Okay, let's say you start investing at 20 and you're now 40 years old. It's been growing tax deferred. If you withdraw, and let's say your money's doubled. Let's say you had 100 grand, it's now 250 grand, and you're 40. Mm-hmm. Might it make sense to actually withdraw that and pay the 10% in that moment, and you still would make out better than if you would have just had it in a regular retirement, a regular investment account?
No. What you want to do is first of all, we have to have a couple other issues in there. Did you change to, did you convert to a, was it a Roth IRA? And hopefully it will be a Roth IRA, and we'd be happy to talk about all the many advantages to a Roth IRA. But in general, and let's talk about what a self-directed IRA is, because, you know, people hear IRA, they immediately fall asleep because they have an IRA. It's never performed very well. They stop contributing to it. You know, why am I even talking about this topic? Well, here's the problem. The problem or the reality. The reality is that IRAs are designed to make a lot of money. As a matter of fact, Congress never set an upper limit on how big the IRA can get.
Mm.
And I can tell you that we know that the largest Roth IRA in the country is a guy named Peter Thiel. And Peter's IRA, and I met Peter. He's a nice guy, very, very intelligent guy. Peter has $1.2 billion in his IRA.
No shit.
Yeah. And when we had dinner together, Peter did not pay.
What?
Now that I think of it.
That's why you got it.